In this video, we'll take a look at how grouping works on our Blazor Grid. You'll learn how to group data in UI and code. I'll also show you interval and custom grouping. So let's get started. I've already added our grid component to an application and bound it to data. I'm using sample data fetched from the Northwind database, and I've created context and entity classes. My grid contains several columns that display information about orders. Order date, product name, country, and so on. First, let's enable data grouping for the grid. Back in Visual Studio, I set the Show Group Panel property to true. Now the grid displays the group panel. Users can drag and drop column headers onto the group panel to group data. They can also drag headers within this panel to change group order. To ungroup data, simply drag the column headers from the group panel back to the column header panel. You can also specify initial group settings. I specify group indexes for the order date and country columns. I also disable grouping for the quantity column. Now when I run the application, the grid already displays group data. I can drag and drop other column headers here. When I try to drag and drop the quantity column header, the data is not grouped by this column. You can also use other API members to manage data grouping. I'll demonstrate how to use the grid's methods. First, I add the @ref attribute for my grid. Then I add two DX buttons to the page and handle their click events. Here I use the grid's group by method, and here I use the expand all group rows method. I run the app. When I click this button, data is grouped by the city column, and this button expands all group rows. Our Blazor Grid also supports interval grouping. For example, you can group datetime values by year, month or date, or group text values by display text or against individual characters. Currently, data is grouped by date displayed in the order date column. Now I want to group orders by year. I use the group interval property to specify this. Let's run the app. Now let's look at how to apply custom logic to group data. For example, I need to group data by unit price with the interval of $10. I change the initial group settings for my grid. I remove the group index properties for the order date and country columns, set the group index for the unit price column, and set its group interval property to grid column group interval.custom. I add several methods to the @code block. This method is a handler for the custom group event. I specify it here. The grid custom group method uses the grid compare column values method to compare column values based on custom logic. I use the event arguments value 1 and value 2 properties to access the current column's values. If the compared values belong to the same group property is set to true. I set the handled property to true to prevent the default comparison mechanism from being invoked. The grid customize group value display text method is used to customize text for group rows. I specify this method as a handler for the customize group value display text event. And run the application again. You can see that data is grouped for the following intervals: $0 to $10, $10 to $20, and so on. And that's it for this video. If you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring that bell so you get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.